Welcome to the Will Edwards Show. On today's show, you're going to find out how I met my special guest in a casino bathroom here in Las Vegas Strip. And you're going to find out all the parts of our musical guest. Wondering who's on the show tonight. Anybody? Anyone? All right, let's just go out to the green room and find out. All right, we're almost up here. And we are up here. Look who it is. Oh, from Fox 5 News, it's Mike Doria. And our musical guest is the real Ulysses. How you guys doing? Thank you for being here. Hey, while we chill out up here in the green room at Show Creator Studios, you guys get an opportunity to check out this recycled sketch. Good to see you. Thanks for coming out, man.
Apple presents the newest, most advanced app in history.
Bullshit app.
So what do you look for in a girl?
Girl, look, I'm simply interested in friendship first and foremost.
Girl, you know that's some bullshit.
Bullshit app.
The Bullshit app is not just perfect in social settings, it's also great for use in the workplace.
So I was wondering about my raise.
Your name is at the top of the list when we start handing out raises next year.
Don't take it bullshit.
Now you know that's a bullshit.
Next year, look out for the Bullshit app too.
You know, a woman's happiness is the only thing that's truly important to me.
Take that, sucker.
You know that's some bullshit.
Download that shit from iTunes.
Here at TC's Rib Crib, we are all about family. If you're looking for the best barbecue in Las Vegas, look no further. And of course, we serve all of the traditional sides. Why not enjoy some fresh brewed sweet tea or Kool-Aid? That's right, Kool-Aid. Oh, and you're gonna wanna save some room for dessert. We offer great weekday lunch specials, and TC's opens early on weekends for the best down-home breakfast in the valley. We're open 7 days a week, 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. at 3655 South Durango, Suite 18. Join our family tradition at TC's Rib Crib for a barbecue experience that will keep you coming back for more.
Welcome to the We Funny Comedy Show here at the Inspire. Welcome back to the show. Our special guest this evening is, well, we love him here at the Will Edwards Show. He was co-host for season 5 here. He is Fox 5 reporter Mike Doria, everybody.
You forgot a whole part of another season.
No, it was actually, I looked back today, 4. It was only 4 episodes.
It was.
Yes.
Remember last season? Well, the only other season I hosted. And I said, what season are we on? Because I thought we were one ahead, and you're at the end to remind me. What was it, season 5?
It was season 5, yeah.
I thought it was like season 4. You're like, Mike, you're on season 5 now.
It was very funny.
Yeah.
Very funny. How are you?
I'm doing well.
What do you think about the dish?
I love it. Well, it's condensed.
Yes.
I'm closer to you, which I'm not a fan of, but I'm working with it.
You love it, and you know
and
it.
And it's brighter.
It is
you
brighter.
You look happier, and not that you didn't look happy before. Don't get it twisted.
Okay,
you just look
right.
Happier.
Thank you.
Yeah.
How is Fox 5 News now?
Fox 5 is great. Well, you watch, right?
I'm assuming. Well, here's what happens
in my house, right? So my wife watches and she goes, "Mike's on!" And we all run in and all the kids, and we all get around the TV and we watch you and that kind of thing.
I would love...
I don't have any kids, by the way.
At some point in my career to say, like, I'm bettering the world, like somebody's getting, like, really useful information out of me.
Yeah, yeah.
The reality is, I think I'm making America dumber, but that's what they want to see.
But like, look, I don't think so. Here's what I do think. I think that you make news fun.
It is, definitely. I mean, if you turn on the, you turn on the news lately, it's all doom and gloom. In fact, I'm pretty certain Armageddon is going to happen next week or the weekend after.
Any minute.
So hopefully this episode airs before that happens. But the reality is, if you're watching news in this day and age and you're not putting any fun, people don't want to wake up to that, especially in the morning. You've got to wake up and brighten up their day. And I'm grateful that I get to do that.
I think you're insane. But let's
it is.
Let's go back, because I think everybody needs to have a bit of a, you know, how did we get here? So, what, 5-6 years ago, you were on Fox 5 News, then you left.
Yeah.
Then you came and you were a guest on our show.
Yes. And you loved me so much.
I loved you so much. I said, let's come back and you let's have you co-host the show, right?
Yeah.
Did I say that?
Yeah. Well, it was around that. Well, I definitely asked you if I could come on the show. I had written a book and you're like, yeah, come on. We met in a bathroom at the Hard Rock. You were creeping me in the bathroom.
It is true. I was with Chelsea Cruz. I was with Chelsea. We were coming to see an event, and I looked over and I'm like, oh my God, it's my Doria.
In my mind, I'm like, I think that's a Will Edwards guy from that show. That, you know what I mean? Like,
so
I followed him in.
It's true, guys. I followed him into the bathroom because I wanted him on the show. I followed him in, and I'm like waiting right at the sink, washing my hands like 16 times. Waiting for him to come out, and he comes out and he's like, oh, hey, Mike Doria, funny seeing you here.
Well, I love that. So I had just gotten done writing that book, right? So I'm like, thank God I had something to go to him with. Like, to be like, can I come on your show? Like, just for no reason, like, just to stare at you. That was at the Hard Rock, right?
It was. Yeah. It was. It was great, though.
That was a long time ago.
Well, we're going to take a quick break. When we come back,
okay,
we're going to do a little test. We're going to test your Will Edwards show knowledge for when you were on the show.
Oh, I'm going to fail miserably.
I know you are, but... it's going to be fun for everybody else. Great. We'll be right back with more Mike Doria.
That's me, Chelsea. As you can see, I have a hard time sleeping and keeping myself occupied. That was until I found out about infomercial products. Since then, I call on my friends to help me test them out. They may call it an unhealthy addiction, but I call it a creative passion, making the world a better place, one test at a time. It's for the guests. For the housewarming? How is this not the coolest thing you've ever seen? That's not rhetorical.
Chelsea, what the actual shit?
It's for the guests.
Oh my God. Excuse me, pooping.
Excuse you's right. Look what you did!
I did that. That's right. That was all me.
Move your feet.
Oh my God.
Move your feet. Are you actually pooping right now?
This very instant, yes.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Here. Try it. Here.
Thank you so much.
I can't believe you. You're pooping! What is wrong with her? Oh my God. Do it for your friends.
Poop?
Oh my God. Gross.
Everybody poops, Chelsea. Read more.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, you should be. This is getting out of hand. Now, can we please talk about this when I'm not pooping?
I'm sorry.
Oh my God.
We'll give this back when you try it. Stop being selfish.
I can still use this as toilet paper.
Don't you dare!
We're back with Mike Doria. The first time you came on the show, you were a guest. You wrote a book.
Yeah.
Tell everybody the name of that book.
It was called It's a Sign, Stupid.
That was a good book.
Yeah.
And then you did a second book.
I did.
And I'm in that book.
You are. Did you get a copy?
No, you didn't give me one.
Did you like one?
Yes. Yes,
all right.
Please.
You log on to www.amazon.com. And you can have as many copies as you want. I think they're like $5.99 now. I lowered the price.
Thank you so much for that.
Give them to all your friends. Buy them and give them away.
I'll figure that out.
And Amazon now, I think you could have it to your door, like literally the next day. Do you ever notice when you buy something on Amazon, I think they have like a balloon flying over your house and drop it to
your house. Amazon Prime. I love Amazon Prime.
Oh, okay.
It's like this. You know, everything is fast. Everything is cheap. Love it, love it, love it.
It's because in this world now, everybody needs everything instantly. Like we can't possibly wait 2 to 3 days
anything. You can get groceries in 2 hours on Amazon, delivered to your house. Did you know that?
No, but why do you need them in like 2 hours?
Maybe you have to poop.
Poop?
Yeah, and you need paper.
Oh. I'm like, you have to eat the food first in order to poop. I'm like, it doesn't work the other way around. You can't poop first. All right, you see where we're going with this.
It depends.
You can.
If I have my coffee, then I have to.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
definitely.
Yeah. All right, let's...
Yeah, I can wait for my groceries. I don't need anything.
You're going to wait? You're
going
to wait and go for it? I'm going to do, like I said to you guys, we're going to do a little test of your Will Edwards show knowledge.
I'm so nervous.
You should be nervous because these are all episodes that you are in.
I know, but like, remember when we used to record like 3 episodes in one day?
That is true.
So I was in a lot of episodes.
You were in a lot of episodes. So here we go. Are you ready?
Yeah.
This is from season 4, episode 14. This was your first episode on the Will Edwards Show as co-host. You ready?
Yeah.
Who was the guest?
Oh, gosh.
Was it A, B.D. Freeman, B, Mindy Totty, or C, Aideen Roth?
It was B.D. Freeman.
That is incorrect. Man, that's terrible. It was Mindy.
Mindy
Totty. Remember that? That was a fun show.
Yeah. No, I do remember Mindy. Totally.
You don't remember the show at all.
Mindy is the one I talked about poop with, right?
Yes.
Yeah, she's a vegetarian.
Yes.
See, I remember all that. I just didn't remember which.
Get it together, sir.
All right.
Okay. All right.
Next.
Season 5, episode 1. This is our premiere episode of the full season that you were the co-host
of. Okay,
which
the
was
crazy
last season.
Came out.
The crazy,
full
all
crazy.
Of it, all of it came out. Who was the guest on that show? Was it A, Ronald Smith? Was it B, Mark Chinook? Or was it C, Heather Collins?
All right, it was either Heather Collins or Mark Chinook. I'm going to go with Mark Chinook.
That is correct!
Yes!
Well done, man.
Yes!
That was good, man. You pulled that one out.
I did.
All right, here we go. Season 5, episode 13.
13?
13. What magician put your cell phone into a balloon?
Oh, gosh.
Was it Murray Sawchuk?
No.
Was it Mike Hammer?
Nope.
Was it Kyle Knight?
Yes.
Kyle Knight it is, man!
I love Kyle and Misty Knight.
I know, they were great. They were great on the show.
They go all over the world now.
They're fantastic.
Yeah.
I love them. So, here we go. Last question.
Yes.
Season finale, season 5.
Season finale, season 5. So the last time you and I were ever going to co-host again.
That is correct.
Unbeknownst to either of us at the
either
time.
Either of us. That
all
is
right.
correct.
Okay.
So, we did the entire show on location.
We did.
Right? So, where did we go? Did we go to Mundo and meet George Harris and shoot some stuff at the World Market Center? Did we go to TC's Rib Crib to talk to Sharon Harrell and then go to Sin City Comedy Show to speak to Michael Ziegfeld? Or did we just do the entire show at the Indie Film Factory with Tori Russell and the Broadway in the Hood cast?
So I believe all of this is true.
Yes.
Like, all of that
Every
is true.
Every bit of it is true.
But Tori Russell, I was there for that episode. That was not the finale.
Okay.
Like, they did their show there.
Look at this guy.
Yeah, because remember we had him in the green screen.
Yep.
I want to say that the finale, we were at Mundo Grill. I remember being there.
Yes.
I don't, and I remember TC's Rib Crib.
Sure.
I don't remember that other one. I don't remember Sin City Comedy. I was
really?
Not there.
You were there.
I was?
Yes.
Oh, over at, yes.
Planet
I was
Hollywood.
There. Planet Hollywood.
Sin City Comic Club at Planet
so
Hollywood.
So, what was A again?
A was Mundo and the World Market Center. Which one was it?
Oh my gosh. I'm going to go with that one.
You're going to go with Mundo?
Yeah.
You are incorrect, sir. The finale was at TC's Rib Crib, and then we ended up doing a thing over at the Sin City
yes,
Comedy.
Yes, we did all of those things.
We did.
The problem
but
is,
you forgot. You weren't paying attention.
I don't even remember what I wore yesterday.
Well, you know
I don't
what?
Even remember how I got here today to be on this show. And you want me to remember back? Like
it's a good thing that we record you a lot. That you recorded on the show and that you recorded on Fox 5.
Yeah.
Because if not, you would know nothing.
Well, Fox 5, is so it's not a whole lot recorded. It's literally all live. But like, you get one take.
And that's it.
Yeah. But, you know, when you do it, like, it's eight times you know, throughout the course of the morning.
Oh.
So, you know, I go in and I'm like, okay, I should read the script a little. You know, I have a little bit of a script. By the fifth one, I'm like, who needs a script? I'm like, just go out and do whatever you want. You know what I mean?
You're just bananas out there.
Yeah. Because you got to hit roll cues. I mean, that's boring for the person at home. But they're like, just go out. Make it fun. You know what I mean?
And you do make it fun. And we appreciate that.
Now
we do. And we want to thank you for coming out. Everybody, check out Mike Doria, Fox 5 News in the morning. You'll have a blast. Trust me. Thank you again.
Thank you.
For being here. Our musical guest is a very, very good friend of mine. I think you are going to absolutely love this guy. Let's check him out. Let me just tell you something. In the world of hip hop, this guy has it going on. Let's check him out. And there he is, everybody. It's Ulysses.
Hey, what's up, man?
How you doing, man?
Good. How you doing?
Hey, listen. Thank you so much for being here. We really appreciate it.
Absolutely.
How's things going?
Man, everything's going great. Blessed, man. No complaints. You know what I mean? Everything just keeps on progressing. I'm in a blessed state. Just got to keep pushing forward, man.
And new baby?
Yes, absolutely. Luna, she came into this world. It's a beautiful feeling, man.
Love it. Love it. Tell us a little bit about the song.
So Don't Let Go is a very special song to me because it is about a point that I hit where I was kind of backed into a wall and left for dead by the people that I cared about because of my dream, because of the passion that I had. So in this video, I wanted to capture the aggression that a lot of people hold inside and never show to anybody. So I show three sides of me in this video. The man that's trying to keep everything balanced, you know, be a man, handle his responsibilities, the man that's chasing his dreams, his passion in the studio, working on music, and then the aggression inside, you know, and the depiction of just keeping everything inside, trying to bottle it up like a calm storm, you know what I mean?
Like
but I want the viewers to see all sides of me as an artist, you know, and what happens in my head. So I'm really excited for everybody to see it, man. It's a great video.
I like it. Let's check it out.
All right.
Gotta seal the case, make up for my mistakes. No way to ease the pain, cause this is what it takes. Hate for you to fall in love with someone else like me. That's perception is much greater than what humans can see. This curse of thoughts that's layered got you tatting up your sleeve. What's worse is I made it farther than most will ever see. prayers cold like an autumn breeze. Honestly, I thought we'd make it. I guess that was naive of me. I'm having a hard time believing that we wasn't meant to be. We went from laying in bed together to torn by my dream. I never saw this coming. When we began to speak, all I wanted was your love, closer than the air I breathe. Loved your son like he was my own, and I did that by choice, because I saw in him what no one ever saw in me. Knew it hit the wrong tone when you heard the music in my voice. And I apologize for not being what you wanted, but I can only be me, and Lord knows it's far from perfect. Go and find you a better man, baby, cause you're worth it. But don't ever sell me short for chasing my high purpose. See, most said it, they do, until it's really time to act. I keep it real, the sight of losing you sent chills down my back. Until it really happened, cause I still can't feel that. Numb like the city sitting on my heels now. When will I heal, huh? I'm in love with the sight of your face, but lost by the sound of the bass. The choices that I made never flattered our fate, so you made them for us. Otherwise I wouldn't escape this wounded maze before the floors collapse. I don't know how to act. Am I forcing all these smiles for the eyes at my back, or my denial about my life and writing rhymes in these raps?
Ooh, when did we go wrong? Ooh, when did we go
If you're looking for something fun and different to eat here in Las Vegas, I think it's time for you to try Stir Crazy Mongolian Grill.
You get to choose from your meat, from beef, chicken, pork, turkey. Okay. So whatever you like, just pile up whatever meat you like. You can mix and match. We chop our own vegetables fresh daily as well. Pile up some red bell peppers in there, mushrooms. And once you've chosen your toppings, we come down here, and most popular is our noodles. Mm. We have to stock these up all day long. One of our sesame oil helps cook on the grill. You're good to go.
Good to go. Let's see how they cook it.
You just bring to the chefs. They're gonna stir fry our food on the grill. The grill's 650 degrees, nice. So they will cook it up.
From all of y'all saying, ooh, Miss Pam, Miss Pam, Miss Pam, Miss Pam, Miss, Miss, Miss Pam. How do we actually make a ghettotini? Now, some of y'all already know how it's done, but you're doing it wrong. Because if you was doing it right, you'd look like this. All right, come on, y'all. Come on in my kitchen. Miss Pam is about to show you how to make a real ghettotini, y'all. Come on. Now, I have been hearing that some of y'all just been pouring alcohol into a glass and sprinkling in the Kool-Aid. Don't you shortchange yourself. Go on ahead and make yourself the Kool-Aid. So you're gonna open up your pack like this, pour your Kool-Aid in there, ooh, girl, and then add some sugar. Add a little extra sugar, if you know what I mean. All right, then you're gonna stir it up, y'all. All right, now you wanna find out, ooh, I gotta find some alcohol up in this house. Ooh, and there it is, Miss Pam got some vodka. And it looks like somebody's been partying before we started. All right, so you just get your shaker. Pour in some alcohol. Ooh, girl, whatever you got in the house will do. Then you get your Kool-Aid and you pour it in there just like this. Ooh, that smell good, y'all. Then you shake it like a toddler. Ooh, I done told you to refresh me. All right, then. Then you get your favorite glass and you pour it up in there and bam! You got yourself a ghettotini, y'all. Y'all get on out of here and make yourself some ghettotini. Come on back and see us next time, right here on Celebrity Chitty Chat Chat with me. Bam! We want to thank all of our guests tonight. Thank you to Mike Doria from Fox 5 News. We also want to thank our musical guest, Ulysses, for coming out and bringing his music video. Oh, I can't end the show without thanking Miss Pam. Thank you so much, Miss Pam, for staying with the show. We'll see you guys next week right here on The Will Edwards Show. Cheers.